modeling the project system and the overview model. So now that we are talking about the how to model the project system, so before that we study the project, we need to model the project. So in this case, we need to consider the form in which objectives are often presented to the project and that in which the analyzed plan will need to be delivered. So okay, what kind of objectives are involved in the project, the how to deliver the NDC delivery plan to meet the two projects, and the analyzing of plans are important factor to model the project. So therefore, the, before you model the project, we have to provide a brief, project brief. Brief must be the very precise. Okay, all the most important requirement has to be mentioned in the brief, and the most concise way of how to present, how to perform the project need to be included. So this is the brief is need to be very precise. So that if the area, any area that are not so precise need to be identified. So that any area which are not so precise need to be identified and then also clarified. Brief must be the open. Brief must be open. So by making an open brief, it will be easier for the project team to perform the job. So after that you finish the brief, we have to write down the proposal. So in this case, this is the how to do the project, how long will it take, how much money will be costing, those must be included in the proposal. So that to write the proposal, important factor has to be considered is who is the proposal for, why is the proposal being requested. These two things have to be concerned. So without concerning them, and then you write the proposal will not meet the targets or requirement. So therefore, the project needs to be two kind of project. One first kind of customer is internet customer. So when you are doing a project for the internet customer, the projects are planned and the outline and the performance need to be consistency with the organization's whole. If you are doing a project for the external customer, so external customer, so then in this case, the payment for the project need to be concerned. So if you are doing this project for the external customer, the payment for the project need to be concerned. So in this case, the those that in the project plan, the appropriate results must be delivered, and project bid must be the competitive because we are using the tendering system. So the tender must be the competitive. Otherwise, the project then will lose the tender. And what will be involved? They should be included. Organizational policy to consider the supplier also had to be involved. So the appropriate result, competitive bid, what will be involved, and the organizational policy to consider the suppliers are the important factor to write down the project proposal. So the project function is a cost and benefit need to be balanced. It costs it too much, so in this case, misuse of planning can make the cost too much. Good use of the planning ways are maximize the benefit. So this is the balancing and the cost and benefit. Planning is important. Planning misuse. So planning is no good, the cost will be very much. And planning is good, so benefit will be maximized. So therefore the planning process is the many input functions. Input functions are we have to provide the project brief, tool and techniques, and project management things, they are the input functions. In the meantime, we have to describe the standard procedure, has to be aware of the financial, die, legal, NPK, strategic, environments. Those factors are all input functions. All factors need to be concerned to plan the project. So then, based on those factors, appropriately address the all the requirements and the project plan and the proposal need to be prepared. So then, when you are writing the project planning, the planning is maybe the very long planning. In this case, where you break down the activities. So all the planning activities need to be broken down, and we have to determine the logical sequence, and input to logical sequence, and the management activity need to be determined, and then the framework for the assessment need to be established. So those are the planning activity. So they break down the activity, determine the logical sequence, input to subsequent management activities, and the framework for the assessment. Now, important factors in the planning process. So that every planning we start, we have to check, stage one finish, check again, stage two finish, check again, stage three finish, check again. Every improvement, every process need to be checked. So this is for the project modeling and the project planning and the project checking system.